Some child predators serve little or no prison time because young victims fear facing them in court.
Well, now a local organization is hoping you can help them get a new piece of equipment to help put these kind of guys behind bars.
Christopher Lukacs raped a four-year-old little girl repeatedly for months. Timothy Armstrong lured a neighbor girl into his home, telling her he'd let her play with his cats, then raped her. Both of these guys could have walked.
At 30 years old, I couldn't hardly talk about it without falling apart. So I can't imagine a 7 or 8 year old trying to testify in a room full of not only strangers, but the perpetrator. I just can't imagine.
And that's the problem. For years, victims like Cindy Smith have been too afraid to testify because they'd have to face their attacker. So even when prosecutors know something awful happened, they can't prove it in court.
There have been dozens of cases where we can't proceed because we have to have the child to testify. And unless we can accomplish that, we don't have the evidence we need to criminally prosecute.
But not anymore. Cindy and the group Hope in Heels are raising money to get simple technology, closed circuit video, that allows children to testify without ever being in the courtroom.
And I feel like this equipment will definitely give them a voice and give them protection.
Prosecutor Megan Shanahan knows it will. Lukacs and Armstrong were convicted, but only because Shanahan got a rare exception, allowing the victims to testify via video.
We have a right and a duty to protect these kids, but we also have a duty to prosecute these offenders, and we can't do that successfully without this equipment.
All right, so the nonprofit group Hope in Heels has already raised $19,000 just in the last couple of months to buy the closed circuit TV equipment for Hamilton County. But they need to raise another $6,000 by the end of the month.